Extinct Legends were out here at the Daytona Speedway for the Turkey Run. Annual car show, car corral, over 5,000 cars on the infield, about 1,500 cars in the car corral. We're out here on Sunday, it's the last day, so we're gonna see what we see out here and stay tuned for more. Sir, can you let me off right here?
What?
You can let me off right here. Extinct Legends, we're out here with Mark. Mark's got this Greenbrier, I believe it's called.
Yep.
And man, this thing is unique, definitely unique. So tell me a little something about this. First of all, where'd you find it? And how long have you had it and what you've done to it? We'll go from there.
I bought the van about 6 years ago in North Georgia. It had just been sitting around in a field for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And I towed it home. And we went through the drivetrain, the brakes, and everything. We had the interior all redone. And we cruised it around that way for a long time. And just a couple months ago, I cut suspension up, bagged it, and put the appliance wheels on it. Just give it a new attitude, you know?
Yeah, it's definitely got some character here. Those wheels, you know, stance is everything, right?
Oh, yeah.
And it's sitting right now. And what year is this?
It's a 64.
64?
Yep.
And I mean, so sitting in the field, so you know, everybody's going crazy over patina, man. And I know you probably don't have any plans to paint it, do you?
Oh, absolutely not.
Yeah, man. I mean, it has so much character, man, and I love it. You know, as I walked over here, man, it definitely stopped me in my tracks. I was like, hey, wait a minute, hold up, I got to talk to your owner. So yeah, this is an awesome build. How long did it take you to really get it the way you wanted, or you didn't have to do too much?
Well, I think it basically at my vision I've had for it the whole time, and like I said, we cruised it around, you know, stock height, stock wheels for a long time, but just a few months ago, like I said, we finally got it to really that point where I wanted it all.
And I think this is what it wants to be, man.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks perfect, man. I don't think you have to do anything else. I mean, it's just amazing. So thanks for taking the time to talk to us about it, man. And
glad you like it.
Yeah, enjoy it, man. Roll it to the wheels fall off. It looks great.
Awesome. Thanks,
man. All right, thanks a lot. Take it easy.
Yeah, you too. I got drive-in movie speakers. That's my stereo. I got Bluetooth radio. I didn't want to cut into the dash, so I got Bluetooth stereo.
Nice.
With subwoofers in the back, and then the drive-in movie theater speakers for the component speakers.
Nice. This is great, man. You did an excellent job, man. It's looking lovely. And it's a stick.
Oh, yeah.
I love it, man. I like the color of the interior as well, man. Beautiful.
Same thing with our green ones.
Mm-hmm.
See, you moved it over here.
Oh, yeah. Almost time to take the jacket off.
Johnson's driving here.
Little walk around right here.
This is the nicest deal.
I knew it was a 68 or back. You know why? Because 69, all cars had to come from the head, from the factory with a headrest. From 68 on down, all cars don't have headrests. From 69 on up, all cars had to have headrests. That's clean up, brother.
Yes, it is.
What price to build that car, you hear me?
Yes, sir.
First time I ever seen one like that. Is it yours too?
No.
Oh, it's not? So you're a Chrysler guy?
Look at this one.
I like the shape on this one.
Yeah. This is like that burgundy one we just saw. Similar car.
But I like how it has like a sharp turn.
Yeah. Dude.